Well, this time again, Derek does it again. He refuses to let me know exactly what's happening in the flick because yesterday, apparently, I was talking too much. Can you believe it? Talking too much, Derek. Well, I'm as excited as you are. Let's head on to the flick. We'll be right back.
Being a brand ambassador for something is not something that just comes with an ease. As the Ugandan movie ambassador, Derek Dasha, I'm always here to give you an update of what is happening in the film industry. And of course, yesterday we were talking to a very beautiful lady as far as Days to Live is concerned. Now, today on the show, we decided to, you know, look into the cast and, you know, get to pick out one other person. It's a very good friend of mine, is an interesting gentleman that you need to talk to one-on-one. Baba Taina Diata Kapoto Mungalo, very, very fantastic. Raymond Roosh, how you doing, big man?
Derek, I don't know. I'm okay. I don't know why you keep persisting.
No, by Derek, the, I mean soda.
Yeah, that's what it's I'm saying. But by the way, it's now 4 years.
4 years?
Unbelievable.
Are you
four
serious?
4 years of non-alcohol.
If Roy can do it, I can definitely
exactly.
did it also.
Yeah, that's what I keep telling people.
How have you been?
I've been okay.
Fantastic.
Just up and down, preparing something, somewhere.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. Let's talk about Days to Live. Mm. Cancer educative story.
Yeah.
Why decide to be part of this movie?
You see, there's been quite a lot of cancer cases. It's been rampant, you know. Scourge is really high, you know, and a few days back, you know, what was going on in the country. And we need this cancer awareness. People don't know, because even they say, I hear that even right now, you or me, we could be having cancer,
okay.
But we are not aware. So trying to advise and talk to people, awaken people, so they go for routine checkups.
The checkups, yeah.
Yeah, so that they don't end up like this guy in this
the
movie.
The robot guy in the movie.
The robot guy in the movie.
Now, talking about the robot guy in the movie, who you happen to play as, what was the biggest challenge for you to take up this role? Because we see you coughing blood in the movie, we see you losing your hair, even to the extent where this lady thinks that you're actually in love with her, things turn south because you are dying. You know, what was the challenging part for you to portray this person?
Actually, I think you've already mentioned the challenges. When I was given the script and I read through the script, because that's what I normally do, I first read through the script before I actually take on the job to see where this role is taking me, how big, how challenging. And like we've always talked, me and you know, it's fun when you meet a challenge and then you overcome it.
Yes.
But my biggest challenge was, I don't know, to act this sick man. The role demands a lot of emotions, as you saw, as you can see in the movie. And so my challenge was how do I get myself into Robert's shoes? And, you know, the idea of, you know, coughing, acting sick, I have to lose my hair. And to be honest, I have never cut my hair to that level. Never.
You did it.
In my 45 years, never.
Okay.
I have never. So those are the challenges, like, but I'm going to cut my hair, how am I going to be looking like? Well, as an actor, I'm not so much concerned about my looks, because once the role calls for that, demands for that, then that's what you have to do. But I was wondering, will I be able to look this sick? Will I be able to convince my audience, my fans, my people?
You even had to lose some weight, you just gained
exactly.
weight
Exactly, yeah, I'm just putting on weight, somewhere, eating something.
Yeah, you're eating some chicken, eh?
No. I do organic food, I do local foods, I don't do
it. How long did it take you to get into character for Robert?
It took me about 3 weeks because one of the ladies called Doreen when she presented the script to me. And then we took like 3 weeks because I told her, first give me some time to think about this role. So it took me like 3 weeks. So I was looking through the film and I was touched. I'm not blowing my own trumpet, but I was touched. I was like, but Raymond, what if this happens to you? Because like you said, you know, once the old time has this issue.
So I said, I understand that.
At some point, this thing comes to me and what will people be saying? They'll be like, hey. Like in Uganda, no man, I take it and I get up. You know, we've been doing people around all that. Like, you know, but yes, I felt it myself. I was like, but now? Are there chances that I may also get into this kind of situation? Have you considering that I was Yes.
A before person. All right.
Yeah.
Now you're probably wondering what exactly happens in this movie. You're probably joining us for the very first time and you don't clearly understand what Days to Live is all about. Here's a trailer to keep you updated as we get back to talk to Raymond.
There's something I wanted to tell you guys.
Yeah.
I went and saw the doctor. Things are not getting any better.
Which one of you guys is going to tell me the dad and that guy?
I've not told you yet. Jerry.
Met someone.
She hot. She is hot. But why would that be your first question?
It's every man's first question, Robert. Come on.
Are you afraid, man?
Why exactly did you come here?
He's your friend.
Get out of my house.
You shared almost a decade with this guy, and he's dying. And all you're saying, you're working?
You're dying?
Yes, there is nothing to really get upset for. Why are you upset?
You made me believe that you might love me. Yet in actresses, you don't even know whether you'll see the next morning.
Oh, Rush, what was your experience like working with all these teammates, and you had new teammates on doing film for the very first time, trying to, you know, expound more on the industry? What was your experience like?
Yes, like I've always said that it's very exciting. It's a few challenges, but I find it very exciting and fun. Every time I have to work with new people, especially guys who are much younger than me, because there's a lot they learn from me, and there's a lot I learn from them.
How do you deal with these young ladies that are your fans and they're asking, Raymond, what is your Snapchat name? What do you tell them?
I tell them you can WhatsApp me. I tell them at least WhatsApp me. Or so many of my friends on Facebook, so maybe I chat with them that side.
Okay.
Yeah, and but I have that problem. Haven't you seen this? You saw my message.
Yes, I did.
The time I created a group, I wanted to be a broadcaster, I created a group.
A group.
And it was a mess.
That group almost caused chaos.
But anyway,
now, let's just aside from Days to Live, we'll get back into that a little bit later on. Let's talk on Mpeke Town. News got to me that you were supposed to be part of Mpeke Town, the biggest drama series that is airing on both Urban TV and Bukede. Saturday on Urban TV at exactly 1 p.m., you should get to watch that. Now, what exactly went wrong? Why aren't you part of Mpeke Town? What happened?
I am part of Mpeke Town.
But we don't see you. In spirit.
Yeah, in spirit.
Okay, so what happened?
But what happened is, around that time, I was supposed to be going to Mpeke, from Mpeke Town in Jinja.
Mm.
Now, the day I was supposed to be going is when I was called for the 27 guns.
Okay.
Because I had auditioned for 27 guys and guns and had a particular role to do in 27 guns. So that day when I was called, actually it was very abrupt because they had to do some rescheduling, the filming schedule. So they happened to call me earlier than I thought for the 27 guns. So by the time the Mpeke Town people called, my phone was off. I was already on the other set in
for 27 guns.
Yeah, for 27 guns. And you know, it took us sometimes some months coming back, and Mpeke Town was gone. But my audience, my fans should rest assured, I'm in the next.
Season 2.
I'm in the next one, season 2.
Come on, buy an imbaya.
Come on, buy an imbaya. We have to be here.
All right, so as we wrap up, we all know that you have a premiere that you've organized for this movie, Days to Live, that is going to be happening on the 6th of July.
Yeah.
Expectations, what should we look out for?
First and foremost, we should look out for me. This time, I'm not going to say what cocktail, what these things. That's not, that's,
but they will
that's
have
minor.
Some yes, cocktail will, for us. They yeah, like yeah, some yeah, of yeah. us. This side.
There will be cocktail, there will be some entertainment and some surprises from some big artists who are my close friends. But above all is what is going to be inside. The movie itself is the most important thing.
All right.
You get. So I'm saying people should come, buy their tickets, and be ready to be touched by this movie.
How much are the tickets going for?
The tickets are VIP is 50,000 and then 20,000 ordinary.
All right, and it's about that time we get to sign up and leave you guys with more of the interesting feedbacks as far as living is concerned. But of course, don't forget, 16th of July, we're holding it down at the National Theater. Come, let's be part of the biggest audience that is going to be embracing Days to Live. And let's not only watch to be entertained, but also watch, learn, and be able to help out a friend as far as a fighting cancer is concerned. Hit me up on my social media, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. That is at Aine Dasha, Aine Derek, and Aine Derek, respectively. You'll be able to get me online. As the Ugandan Movie Ambassador, allow me to sign out. I'll see you guys next time we meet.
We'll be taking a quick break, but when we come back, we'll be heading for Woman Crush Wednesday. And I already spilt it. It's a man for Woman Crush Wednesday. So stay hooked.